Hello everyone, I'm Rupali Meshram. Today we are going to see Standard 4th Environmental Studies Part 2, Chapter Number 2, Work of Sons. In previous two periods, we had discussed about this topic. About Sri Chakradhar Swami, we had seen. About Sant Namdev, Sant Nyaneshwar. This was the last part. Today we are going to study about Sant Eknath. Here, picture of Sant Eknath they had given. Let's see the content. Sant Eknath. Sant Eknath carried on the work started by Sant Namdev and Sant Nyaneshwar. So as Sant Eknath, whatever the work was started as to give devotion to God and to motivate the people, this was the way of Sant Namdev and Sant Nyaneshwar. This was followed by Sant Eknath. He lived in Paithan. Sant Eknath was living in Paithan. He preached that the way of to reach God was through devotion, Bhakti Mark. So as his teaching was, if you want to reach to God, that the way for it is devotion to God. That is the Bhakti Mark he taught to the people. He wrote numerous religious songs, abhangas, as like the Sant Namdev was writing kirtans, composing kirtans, different songs and stories. Like this only, the Sant Eknath, he was writing religious songs as like abhangas, ovis and bharuds. His advice to the people was not to accept any distinction of high and low, as he was teaching to the people. Through his abhangas and through his ovis and bharudis, he was teaching the people that not to discriminate the people on the basis of high and low, that is rich and poor. He made friends with the poor and the downtrodden and taught them devotion to God. So as he made friendship with the poor people and who are backward people, and he taught the devotion to God to them. His love extended even to the dumb animals. He exhorted the people to love all living beings and practiced what he preached. So as not only he taught the people to love each other, but also he explained the importance of animals and the animals who are dumb, that animals care. He started, and also he taught people to care, to love to animals and to love all the living beings who are in this world. One day he was going to the river Godavari for a bath. It was noon and very hot. The sand bed along the riverside was very too hot. He heard the crying of a poor child sitting on the hot sand. Eknath looked around and saw the child. He rushed to him and looked around for the child's parents. He picked up the child in his arms, wiped his tears and reached him home. In this way, by his personal example, Eknath impressed the message of love and equality on the minds of the people. So as this is one short story which was related to Sant Eknath. As through his story, we can come to know that how he was love to the people. He was not making any discrimination between the rich and poor. As indirectly, without thinking the caste discrimination, he took that child into his arm and he took that baby to his home. The next content we are going to see, that is Sant Tukaram. Two great sons, Tukaram and Ramdas, lived in Shivaji's time. Tukaram came from Dihu near Pune. He owned a farm and also a grocery shop. His forefathers used to lend money to the needy people. But this is the picture of Sant Tukaram. But Tukaram drowned in the river Indrayani. All the record of loan paper he had, thus giving relief to many. He would go to the neighboring hill and sing songs in praise of God Vitthal. So as about Sant Tukaram, they are given here. The two great sons, Tukaram and Ramdas, they were lived at the time of Shivaji Maharaj. Tukaram, he came from Dihu, which is near Pune, and he owned a farm and a grocery shop. His father was a lend money. He used to lend the money to the needy people. But at that time, Tukaram drawn in the river Indrayani all the record of loan paper he had, thus giving relief to many. So as to make the people who was lending money to relieve them, for this he thrown all the record of loan paper into Indrayani river. He would go to the neighboring hill and sing songs in praise of God Vitthal. So as he all the time he was going to the near neighboring hill, and he was singing songs which is related to God Vitthal. On the 11th day Ekadashi of the month of Ashar and Kartik, he would go to Pandharpur. So as he was a devotee of God Vitthal, so as after every month or 11, on the 11th day of Ekadashi of the month of Ashar month, and at the Kartik, at that time he was going to Pandharpur to devote his song and to show his devotion towards Vitthal. Abhangas and perform kirtans. So as to the devotion, whatever the devotion songs he prays, that all abhangas and kirtans he played at that place, that is Pandharpur. Thousands flocked to listen to him. Shivaji Maharaj also attended his kirtan. So as many people, he was supporting him and loved his abhangas and kirtans. So as many peoples, they were coming there to listen the kirtan and abhanga of Sant Tukaram. Also Shivaji Maharaj, he attended a kirtan of Sant Tukaram. Sant Tukaram preached to the people about the virtues of pity, forgiveness and peace of mind. As Sant Tukaram, he teach the people that whenever if anyone is had done some mistake, so as what we have to do, we have to praise him, means we have to forgive him. If anyone had done any mistake, we have to forgive him and we have to give a chance. So as also he taught the people to change the mindset and also to accept the new things, not to discriminate the people, not to discriminate the people on the basis of caste, color or greed. He also gave them the message of equality. Also he taught no one should discriminate on the basis of rich or poor. Each and every living beings are equal. This was the teachings of Sant Tukaram. He alone is a Sant, and God dwells with whom who calls the weak and the downtrodden as his own. He impressed this truth on the minds of the people. He made them think. So as according to this content, he also gave the message of equality to all, and also he was only a single son who tried to give importance to God also and to the human beings also. As the God is important in our life, like this only the peoples are also important in our life. As we with the devotion we pray to God, like this only with whole devotion we have to respect the human beings. People accepted him as a great religious leader and showered their praise on him. So as by attraction of his thoughts, many people he started accepting him and his thinking, and with a great religious, and he and all the people, they had thought that he is a great religious leader to the people, and they had showered their praise, their devotion towards Sant Tukaram. Even today all over Maharashtra we hear people proclaiming Gyanoba Tukaram, the names of the two great sons. Sant Gyaneshwar is called Gyanoba. Also even today Tukaram Gatha is read in every household. Yes, Gyanoba Tukaram, these are the words that while doing the Varkari Vari, at that time we listen this type of words. So as people at the time of Ashadi Ekadashi, at that period we listen this type of words, which is devoted to the two sons, great sons, that is Sant Gyaneshwar is called Gyanoba, and Gatha, which is of the Sant Tukaram Gatha, which is read in some people's हाउस। समर्थ रामदास। एट द सेम टाइम द हिल्स एंड वैलीज ऑफ महाराष्ट्र वर फिल्ड विद द इकोस ऑफ जय जय रघुवीर समर्थ, ग्लोरी बी टू द ग्रेट रामा, an invocation constantly on the lips of the great Sant Ramdas. Ramdas was born at Jamb on the river of the Godavari in Marathwada. His birthday falls on Ramanavami, the day on which the great hero Rama was born. Narayan was his real name, but he preferred to call himself Ramdas, the servant of Rama. Through his great book Dasbodh, he taught men the ways of good life. Through his Manachi Shlok, that stanzas addressed to the mind, he gave people lessons in good thoughts and good conduct. To popularize the work of strength, he raised the temples of Hanuman, the god of strength. He exhorted people to be strong and told them of the power that resides in the united people. He taught them to organize themselves and fight against injustice. This gave courage to the people. So as Samarth Ramdas, as many times in Maharashtra, in some parts we had listened this type of words, Jai Jai Raghuveer Samarth, as he was the devotee of Ram. So as he called himself, actually his name was Narayan, but he called himself as Ramdas because he was the devotee of Rama. So he called himself that Ram. He is the Das of Ram. That is, togetherly these two words, Ram Das. As Manachi Shlok and Das Bodh, he taught the people from this book. And Manachi Shlok, these are the stanzas which addresses to the mind of the people. Also, he gave people to listen good thoughts and good conduct. What are the good lessons? What are the good thoughts? How we can improve yourself? That he teach from his speeches. To popularize the worship of strength of Hanuman, he raised the temples of Hanuman. So as Hanuman is strength, as according to the Hanuman strength, each and every person should be as strong like Hanuman. So he taught the people that when all the people will be united togetherly, then we will have the power like Hanuman. He taught them to organize themselves and fight against injustice. So as Samarth Ramdas, he taught the people, whenever you are in any problem, that time togetherly when you will try to solve that problem can be solved easily. The work of the sons brought about a great awakening among the people. Religion once again became a thing to be respected, and a spirit of self-reliance was born. People regained their lost confidence. This great awakening among the people brought about by the sons helped Shivaji in his fight for Swaraj. So as at that time we were fighting for our self-independence, that is for Swaraj we were fighting. So as for this, his thought has reorganized the minds of people, and the people's strength has increased to fight against their right. So in this way, we had completed our today's topic. Today we had studied about Sant Eknath, Sant Tukaram and Samarth Ramdas. So as all the three and all the sons' teaching was devotion to God and a good conduct of each and everyone's life. To maintain equality, not to discriminate between the people on the basis of rich, poor, color, their religion or on other manners. This was the teaching of all the sons. So in this way, we had completed this topic. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for my latest notification. That's all for today. Thank you.